from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Things are getting back to normal today in Jay after yesterday's 10-hour standoff at the Verso Paper Mill. Police say 49-year-old Frank Smith was armed with a shotgun when he went to the Verso Paper Mill's administration building at about 8:30 Wednesday morning. Investigators say that he kept the mill's manager hostage for most of the day before releasing him at about 3:30 in the afternoon. Schools were on lockdown during that standoff. Residents of Jay say although things are getting back to normal, they aren't the same.
Back to normal, I don't know. I mean, I think people will be watching their back more, wondering, you know, is this going to happen again?
Our biggest concern was always the safety of our employees, the well-being of our employees. I know a lot of folks in the community have family members and friends and coworkers here.
A spokesperson for the Verso Mill says the company made counselors available for employees today. Of school choice, a hot-button topic at the State House. Debate today on a pair of controversial bills that the governor is proposing. Maine's education commissioner says the bills would open access to those Maine students who don't come from a family with financial means. It would also allow students to choose to attend a private or religious school using public funds. Opponents say this will be a radical departure from the status quo and will cause some school districts millions of dollars in lost funds if the students are allowed to take public funds with them to pay for private education.
We've cut over 100 jobs in the last 3 years because of the recession. So if I lose $7 million, it represents about 8% of my budget. That means many, many more jobs would be lost. $1 million is about 20 jobs. So if I lose $7 million, it's 140 positions.
I don't see this as necessarily resulting in schools closing. I mean, if when you give parents an option, they all pull their kids out and leave, then you've got a problem. But school choice isn't the problem. The problem is you've got a school that parents can't wait to get out of.
The impression from committee members was this is a complex issue that needs further study. That will happen during the upcoming workshop sessions. But with time running out for this current legislative session, at least one member said it is likely this issue will be pushed to the next session. A Maine Supreme Court has signed off on a regulatory agency's approval of a massive residential development in the Moosehead Lake region. The court ruled the Land Use Regulation Commission did not violate rules when it gave the green light to the concept plan. The plan by Plum Creek calls for nearly 1,000 house lots and two resorts with more than 1,200 housing units at Big Moose Mountain and Lily Bay. Environmentalists have been divided over the plan. While taking over the State House, more than 100 girls spent a day at the Capitol wearing T-shirts that read, "Eighth Grade Girls Rock the State House." They took part in mock public hearings, press conferences, and tours of the House and Senate chambers. The girls are all in the eighth grade and come from schools from Madawaska to York. The purpose of the day is to teach girls about the legislative process. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.